Hey guys, I'm Bryce Neal, welcome to my show, and today we're about to take a look at Graham's girlfriend Savannah and see exactly her entire portfolio at age 21. Now mind you, she's like 2 years younger than me, so I'm interested to see exactly how she invests her money, especially she's Graham's girlfriend, she probably gets a lot of good advice. I'm interested to find out. If you are too, stick around for this video. And on top of that, if you want to be on my show here, just send me an email. My email is down below, Tommy Bryson Show, and that way you can come on the show with me and have a conversation about finances or whatever you want to talk about. Now, without further ado, I post videos on this channel every single day. So make sure to also turn it down, hit the bell so you're notified every time I post a video. And on top of that, also destroy the like button. Now, let's see exactly how Savannah here, Graham's girlfriend, goes ahead and invests her money.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's your girl Savannah Smiles. So this has been a highly requested video and I'm finally gonna get around to it. So this is the first time on my channel I am talking about money.
Oh, that is interesting. I didn't know it's the first time she talks about money. And it's also interesting that she's also like a new YouTuber, but she talks as if like, hey, she's been here for a while, very comfortable. Let's hear.
My income is not close to Graham's. I am nowhere close to being a millionaire, which I think is fair because he has a whole 8.5 years on me.
I definitely get that, you know, because again, she's like 21, Graham's like 30, and I think I'm like 23. I think I'm 23, but obviously I'm 23 years old. And the idea is, you know what, Graham has 8 years on top of her. On top of that, she started like recently. I've been starting since I was like 15 years old, so that's why I'm ahead as I am ahead. But you know, if I was like a normal college student, I would have probably been waiting until I'm 24 to get my life started, you know. But at 21, she's still pretty early on. So when she's 30 years old, she should be pretty solid also.
I am not a millionaire. I make a very average income and I worked multiple jobs really since I graduated high school at 17 years old. And even—
Oh, wow. So she works multiple jobs since she graduated high school at 17 years. I also graduated at 17 years old. You know, the idea is when you first get started, it's important to try out various different jobs while you're also trying to get your career together. And that way you can get some income and use that income to make more money, but never just take jobs to kind of like supplement you and kind of like, okay, let me do this just to make some money. The answer is usually what I do is when I first started out, I took on a lot of jobs, but just to test it out and to see what I liked, you know? And some jobs made me a lot of money, but I didn't like them. Like, you know, like the film industry. Some jobs made me a little bit of money, but I actually enjoyed them, like editing for people. And you know, the idea is you try different things out, see what you like, and then you build your own career based on that, okay? Unless you want to be like a normal employee, that's also fine. But you never want to be stuck in that like part-time job or like part-time salary, because in reality, you can't really get anywhere with that. You know, you got to improve your skills to actually make more money.
Even before then, constantly babysitting, and I kept this money sitting there to make this account. I had a minimum wage job that I let go of last year while having other regular nannying jobs while working full time. My main account is through Fidelity. However, I do have other fun money accounts.
By the way, Fidelity, solid account. Do I use it? The answer is no, but solid so far. The idea is that she's been having multiple jobs, but she's always found a way to basically invest the money. By the way, you can tell that she's like kind of like scattered. She didn't really plan this video that well, but again, she just started YouTube out, you know? So I get it.
In apps like Robinhood and Webull, but this one is my main one I focus on. This is my biggest one. The other thing I want to say is that a Roth has a max contribution limit every year. This isn't like I was given a huge money sum. This has been my money from working multiple jobs. So this is an account that I have poured a lot of my money and time into, but the only—
Okay, so just to summarize all this here, okay, because I watched like over like, you know, like a whole 2 minutes of this, and it's like she's saying the same thing over and over. The idea is she uses a Fidelity account as her main account, invests money into that, but it's in a Roth IRA, so it's like capped at $5,000 or $6,000 every single year, and she just invests that money into that from her jobs. All right. Now let's hear the details.
The only way I was able to do that was because my parents let me live at home and they let me stay past the age of 18. They let me stay completely free because my parents wanted me to be able to build this account. They saw how passionate I was about it and they wanted—
It's interesting how like in America, you know, it's like an American thing, you know, in America it's always like, you know what, past 18, you gotta go, you know? It's such a weird thing, you know? I get the whole thing, like, living with your parents. I still live with my mom, believe it or not, while making, like, $25,000 a month, you know? And the answer is weird, right? But the idea is, when I move out, I wanna make sure, like, A, I'm financially free. I'm not really financially free, but the idea is I want to move out to my own property. And I think a lot of parents that cannot kind of like handicap their kids by moving them out like so early. Like, you just finished high school, move out my house. You know, the idea is, how are you supposed to go into college? Well, go get some debt. And then once you get that debt, you go into credit card debt trying to survive. And it's kind of like a very weird way to kind of like put in independence. You know, independence doesn't come from like, hey, go out on your own. It comes from like, hey, here's what you're supposed to do. And then here's how you get it. And then here's what you can do it to actually like not get yourself into massive debt. So I agree with this right here.
I wanted me to be able to build a good future for myself. So I was extremely blessed, and I would not be here without my parents letting me do that. The other thing I
that's awesome.
Want to say is that all of my AdSense, I joke about it going into gardening or groceries or whatever all the time. I take whatever that makes and I immediately throw it into here. After I am done throwing it into here, I will probably use it to help pay for some of the stuff like this or different stuff for the channel right now.
All right, so obviously, like, all the money that she makes from Google AdSense, she just reinvests into the channel, or for example, puts it into her investment account. Okay, decent.
Now I've been using my main income to invest into this, which is so exciting. Anyways, let's get into the video. Okay,
by the way, if I was her and I was like 21 years old and I was like Graham's girlfriend, in this case I'm not, unfortunately, okay? But the point is, you know, I would definitely like, you know, capitalize off of YouTube. I think Graham would say the same thing, and try to make videos like 3 times a week or like every single day like I do, and just post content like over and over again. You know, obviously people are interested in her, and also she has like a huge audience behind her, like Graham's audience. So it's very easy, or like easier, to kind of like build an entire audience. So I would definitely recommend she goes ahead and just pushes YouTube like all the way through. It's very important.
So my main investment account is a Roth IRA. I think you're supposed to say IRA. I'm gonna just call it a Roth from.
This is a Roth IRA, it's fine.
From now on. And that account at this current date of Saturday, June 6th, 2020.
Oh my gosh, she's getting really good at placing ads. You know, that I think Graham taught her that, you know, place the ad where people are interested, nice.
Is worth $28,080.88.
Oh. That is incredible. 28,000 and some odd cents or whatever at age 21. Okay, while working multiple jobs, that is amazing. Okay, that's amazing. Now, since it is a Roth IRA, I think Roth IRA is like are capped like $6,000 contribution every single year, but it keeps going up every single year. So the idea is she's been investing diligently for a very long time, maybe like 3 years or so. So I respect that. Actually, maybe even more than that. Yeah, surprisingly, maybe more. Oh, she's probably talking about the value, and also the investment she has in there has grown also. But yeah, that's awesome. Congratulations, 21 years old. That's an incredible number.
Oh my gosh, I had the most amazing day on Friday. I literally went up $1,000. So the majority of this account is actually...
Yeah, right now the market is going up like crazy, but I wouldn't look at like the short-term gains, because in reality, a Roth is like for like, you know, long-term like retirement stuff. You can take it out if you want to, no penalties, but the idea is, you know, it's like long-term. Everything's like long-term. So like the short-term, you're gonna have days where you're like, oh my gosh, I made so much money. You're gonna have days where you lose a lot of money, and you have to keep like, you know, focus of like, hey, doesn't matter. I'm here for the long run. So long run.
In individual stocks. I don't recommend doing this. Do as I say, not as I do on this, but the majority of my money is in individual stocks. I'm going to be going over those individual stocks with you. Holy crap.
Okay, so here's my thing. She just said, you know what? I don't recommend you invest into individual stocks, but she does. And she says, do as I say, don't do as I do. It's a very common phrasing for people that do things that, you know, they don't really recommend. And the idea is, you know what? I don't care what you do. I care about if you have the information and the knowledge to actually operate in the way you actually operate. So for example, if she understands how to analyze companies, how to understand basically intrinsic value, growth, balance sheets, income statements, you know, the whole nine yards, the SEC website, everything with like all the earnings reports, then I give her like, oh my gosh, do whatever you want to do. But if she's just like guessing like, hey, let me buy some Tesla, let me buy some Delta, let me buy this because of this, then I'm not happy with it whatsoever, especially when you're investing this money for your, you know, like your retirement. Not a smart idea. If you don't know what you're doing, invest into like an index fund, okay? And just call it a day. The S&P 500 is a really good one.
The first stock I'm going to talk about was a really bad investment for myself. That is going to be Capri Holdings. That is a group that owns several designer brands. Like,
wow. Capri Holdings LTD. She invested, okay, she invested $667 and she lost 31% of her value. Wow. You know, I'm so scared, okay? I'm so scared whenever somebody invests into something without having knowledge. And here's why, right? I haven't heard the whole story yet, so I'm just like making an assumption here. If she has like part-time jobs, and I'm assuming she's also getting part-time money, like for example, like minimum wage, right? So for example, she's making like, you know, $15 an hour, maybe like 20 bucks an hour. That's like not part-time job or like minimum wage jobs at all. Say for example, she's making like $20 an hour. And by the way, that's not minimum wage, but just for example, right? $20 an hour. And she lost like $300 right off the bat, right? So $300 divided by 20, well, whenever she sells, if she does sell, the answer is, you know what? You just lost 15 hours of your time, like hard work. That's why I'm so careful with investing. And I only invest into what I know and also what I understand. I don't go based on like, hey, I like this company. This company is so cool, you know? Like, no. Let's hear it out though.
Like Michael Kors and I believe Louis Vuitton, I could be wrong, could be Louboutin because I just learned that there's a difference between the two. They are operating out of China. So when everything first started there, I invested in. So in February of this year, I bought 32 shares at $977.60.
Oh, wow. She bought like almost $1,000 worth and her account balance is like down to $600. You know, you need rules. You know, whenever you're investing in things, you need rules. Like, for example, one of my rules is basically, you know what? If I go below 15%, I'm out. I sold. You know, if I go above 50%, I basically sell also. But now I invest for like the long, long run. You know, so I'm not doing any of these rules anymore. But the idea is when you're investing like this, like trying to make some quick money, and usually you're going to go left if you don't understand what you're doing. You want to have rules to make sure you protect yourself.
Currently, this stock is at $20.86 a share. This was a bad investment for myself, but I'm just holding it until hopefully it evens out with everything starting to reopen. The stock has been going back up.
Okay, so it looks like the stock was, you know, affected by the pandemic in a sense, right? But here's the thing, right, Savannah? You know, when you buy a stock, you can't buy stocks based on what you like or what you think, you know. You want to buy stocks based on basically the facts, the financials, right? So that's the balance sheet, the income statement, and also the cash flow statement, the growth of the company, the earnings potential, and also the S forms. You have to read everything, the 10K forms, the 10Q forms. Like, all this stuff is important because basically it gives you a financial outlook of the real company and its true value. But if you're just investing based on, hey, I like this company, Louis Vuitton, this brand is here, Michael Kors, you know, the answer is it doesn't matter. You know, you have to go based on the financials, and once you do that, you can set a target price based on the research, and that way you know, hey, I'm buying at a discount, so I'm good to go. And even if it goes down because of the pandemic, all you do really is buy more if it's below your target price, because you know exactly what you're doing. But when you're just guessing, it's very dangerous.
I'm hoping just at this point to make a few dollars per share. Bad investment on this one. I am starting this off really solid. And then the next one I am invested in is Delta Airlines. I was a little early on the bottom of this.
Oh yeah, Delta. So Delta, I remember Graham. Graham also bought some Delta stock. I remember he posted like an Instagram story about it. Yeah, a little early on it, you know, but the idea is if you're in it for the long run and you have a target price and you're good to go, you know what? Because I bought Delta also and I'm up like 15 to like 18% because again, my target price was pretty solid, right? I'm not investing based on like, hey, airlines are going down, let me invest. The answer is no. You want to basically understand what you're doing and not take guesses. It's very easy. I don't know why it's so easy to put money that you work for so hard and risk it out there. Maybe for the gambling, maybe for like the profit margins or whatever you can potentially get. But be very, very careful with that. You know what? Once you understand the true value, you're good to go. And by the way, the worst thing that can happen to a stock is not like you lose some of your money. The worst thing is you go down to zero. So you never really know. So don't just base it on like, hey, it's going to go back up. You have to understand the companies fully.
I first bought this stock on March 5th of this year. I bought 4 shares for $45.31. Currently, I have lost $44 on that initial investment. I missed when this bottomed out.
Yeah, so she lost like not that much money, right? But say for example, I own like 600 shares of Delta. Imagine if I bought like this, you know, but I bought like at the top, not knowing exactly what the true value was. Very dangerous, you know, and the more money you make, the more you keep investing over time, this will be a ton of money. So you want to make sure you know exactly what you're doing. If you don't want to do all that work, that's fine. Just invest into an index fund like the S&P 500. Just track the market. That way you'll be good to go when you retire, but be very careful with this.
I kept dropping, so I kept buying more. March 9th, I bought another share of this for $44.63. Again, I have lost money on that initial investment. I didn't really care once the market started dropping. I just started investing in, expecting that it would bounce up higher. So even if I wasn't quite getting the best price, I didn't want to miss out on it entirely. And then again, the next day, I bought another share for $43.44.
Okay, so she keeps buying and buying and buying more. And by the way, Delta went all the way down to $17, by the way. Yeah, my girlfriend actually bought at that price.
And then finally, the next day on the 11th, I bought 10 shares for $43.88. Currently, this stock is priced at $34.16. This next one is disproportionately the majority of my account. And this one is the one that I am super proud of. And that is going to be Enphase Energy. The first time I invested into Enphase was October 18th of 2018.
Wow, so she has almost a total gain of 962%. That's insane. She owns 20 shares and has a value of around $1,000. That's awesome.
I bought 20 shares at $5.14 a share. I got that one way before it was up at what it is now. So kind of just a little fun fact on that. Fidelity for me breaks down exactly how much I've made from each time I've bought it in. And for this one, I have made just under $1,000 on that initial investment. So
yeah, that's awesome.
Around March, I saw that the stock was doing really well and it was going up. So I decided I'm going to throw more money into this.
Oh, that's not what you want to do. That's not what you want to do. When like a stock is going up and doing like very well, usually, okay? It's kind of like, you know what? It's like Warren Buffett says, you know what? When everybody is fearful, you want to be like the hero. When everybody's trying to be like a hero, you want to be very fearful, okay? You want to be very careful what you invest your money into, especially people like driving the price up. Let's find out what she did.
So on March 27th, I bought 10 shares for $9.21 a share. In May of that year, I saw, again, it's still going up. On May 20th of 2019, I bought...
Okay, guys, so this video is about to be very, very long, but I'll sum this up for you. And just to do like her the justice, I'm going to take a look at the end of the video, and then I'll give you guys my exact thoughts on this investment method that she's actually utilizing.
There was a lot of little trading. I had a little bit of money left over, so I bought another share for $41.36. And that's all I've bought on United. I trusted Delta a little bit more than I trusted United because I had heard that Warren Buffett was in Delta. You probably have noticed that there was a lot in the same time period, and I was just kind of...
All right, guys, so overall, I got my full picture here. The idea is that she's investing into individual stocks with the wrong concept, okay? I heard, for example, I thought this, Warren Buffett said this, I bought at this price, I made this much money here. You know, just because you get something right the first time doesn't mean you're going to get it right every single time if you don't know exactly what you're doing. So what you want to do is kind of increase your odds of actually getting success. This right here, I'm going to be 100% honest, okay? It's not investing. It's called speculating. The idea of like saying like, hey, the stock market went up, so I invested more. It went down, so I bought more. I bought this stuff because it went down. The answer is that's all speculating, okay? What the stock market is an exchange for businesses. That's all it is, right? So in reality, when you invest into a company, you're buying a piece of a business. So if you don't understand that business and its true value, you're not really investing, you're speculating. And you're putting a lot of your money at risk. You know, my overall recommendation would be this. You know, I like the initiative of investing this much money by age 21. That's incredible. But the last thing I want is for her to make a total mistake. And next thing you know, she loses a ton of money. So my recommendation is always like, hey, if you want to learn how to invest exactly, read the book called The Intelligent Investor by Benjamin Graham. That's the guy that taught Warren Buffett. If you want to learn about index funds and why they're so good, then read the book about the little book about common sense investing by Don C. Bogle, and also take courses on investing. They cost like $16 on like Udemy, okay? So the idea is all of the information is out there literally almost for free. So you want to go ahead and do that. By the way, I have a link down below for Audible. If you want to sign up, you get 2 free books, the 2 books I mentioned. And on top of that, even if you cancel, you still get to keep the books forever. So that's like free stuff right there, free info, okay? But overall, I don't recommend this at all. I think she's making a mistake, and I think Graham would agree with me on this. And the idea is that, you know, investing is very cool, very exciting, but you can lose a ton of money if you don't know what you're doing. You can get very lucky. So if I was Savannah and I just wanted to worry about like, hey, I just want to get a passive income, I want to grow my money over time, invest into an index fund. If you want to learn how to invest and actually pick stocks, then learn exactly how to invest to understand companies. It's the best thing to do, because when you're making this much money, not a lot in this case, right? You're not making a ton of money. You're making like minimum wage money plus some YouTube money. The idea is that your money and your time are closely together. So the more money you lose, the more time you lose, and you won't get that time back because you work for that money very, very hard. So be very careful. But overall, guys, pretty good video. I'll check out some more later on. Comment down below. Let me know what you thought about this video and what you thought about your investment strategy. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching. And before I go, make sure to smash the like button, also subscribe button, and notification bell so you get notified every time I post a new video. And on top of that, follow me on Racing. And before I go, if you want to watch another video about basically how Warren Buffett thinks about investing, well, here's a video right here. Comment down. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching. And as always, peace.